is Dockridge High, a school just like yours, a school like any other. A place where bright young minds are taught by some of the wisest, most respected members of the teaching profession. Our cameras filmed for a year to find out what life is really like for the students and their teachers at this most ordinary of schools. Welcome to Class Dismissed. It's the start of a new day at Dockridge High, but already the deputy heads are involved in a fight in the playground. Head teacher Mr. Barker is known for his inspirational assemblies.
Thank you, Mr. Barker, for those inspirational words, particularly the part about acceptable school behaviour.
I think we should all follow Mr. Barker's advice where behaviour is concerned.
So, as Mr. Barker has been called away on urgent business...
I think he's already done his business.
...as your deputy head...
And me as your deputy head...
...to announce that today Dockridge High will be visited by a VIP.
VIP.
What VIP?
Oh, did Mr. Barker not tell you? Oh, I'm sorry, I've been sworn to secrecy, but there will be an assembly this afternoon in honour of our guest.
She doesn't even know who it is.
I do, but I'm under strict instruction not to tell anybody, especially not you.
You don't know.
You don't know how to put your shoes on.
You're stupid.
Oh, I know you are. What am I?
Another legendary assembly.
So who do you think this special guest is?
Dunno. Mark, ask your mum.
She's not my mum.
She is.
Is not.
She is.
Is not.
But seriously, who do you think it is? Should I go home and get my makeup? I'm seriously excited about this VIP. I reckon it might be Rita Ora.
Or Andy Murray.
Or the Queen.
Bill Gates.
David Beckham.
Beyonce.
Kate.
Oh, Mr. Tumble. He's awesome. Have you seen the one where he falls over, gets the pie? So funny, man.
Mark.
Yeah, you're right. He's too famous. It's probably the Queen.
Art teacher Miss Flip is about to unveil a special surprise for the VIP.
Now, as you know, we have a very special guest visiting the school today, which is why Mr. Barker has agreed to let us display one of Dockridge High's most prized possessions in our sculpture corner. Oh, isn't it wonderful? So... delicate.
What's
so...
it supposed to be, miss?
Well, that's the beauty of modern art, Emily. You don't have to know.
If you don't know what it is, miss, how do you know when it's finished?
Finished? Yes. I wonder if it could be even better if I added just a... one more thing?
I don't think you should, miss.
You're right. Stand back, everyone. Art!
Site manager Dave is patrolling the corridors.
There's a VIP in town, and by town I mean school. So, as the site manager, I have to stay on my toes. And by toes I mean toes.
Kev to see! Omid, are you receiving me?
Copy that, Kev. Over.
Toilets, over!
10-4, I'm on my way. Right, out of the way, emergency! Gangway, this is not a drill! Emergency!
In honour of today's special visitor, Mr. Christopher is teaching Year 8 a dance routine based on the musical Cats to perform at this afternoon's assembly.
We're crawling. So whenever there's a visitor at the school, I always do a bespoke dance piece, and they just expect it of me, and they don't even need to tell me to do it now. They don't need to, because I will deliver.
Spin! And hold your positions! And relax. Okay, everyone, huddle in. Huddle in. Chop, chop. Dooby, dooby, dooby. No one panic. But the assembly for the VIP is this afternoon, and if you lot do then what you did just now, I will literally die. And breathe. Okay, so let's all give it another go. But if you don't get it right this time, I will have to do it on my own. Solo. Okay, so let's shake out. Shaking
Sir.
Out. Okay, shaking
Sir.
Out. I can't hear you because I'm shaking out.
Sir, I need the toilet.
Fine. Just go. Amateurs. Okay, everyone, so let's go from the top, which is what professional dancers call the start. And remember, we're meant to be doing Cats. So let's try and channel our inner... Okay, triangle, Martin. Space. And 5, 6, 8. And I'm a cat. Meow. I'm a cat. Meow. Okay. Work it. Work it. Oh, that's terrible. Okay, stop working it and watch me work it. I'm a cat. That's it. I'm a cat. Meow. I'm a cat.
Self-taught.
Don't panic! I got towels! No! There were no paper towels!
It's all right, I wiped my hands on my trousers.
On your trousers? Oh, I've let you down. I let the whole school down! There's only one thing I can do. Resign!
Refile.
Or refill them. Yeah. Okay.
Over in science, the pupils are preparing for another potentially hazardous lesson with Mr. Nasal.
Okay, quieten down, quieten down. Now get out your books and your pens and pencils, please. Okay, class, turn to page 33. Oh, Emily, don't tear. Don't tell me you've forgotten your science book, but you've remembered to bring... What is this?
Moisturiser, sir. You know, to stop your skin from drying out.
Moisture for your skin? Oh, no, thank you. It sounds disgusting. Unusual fragrance, but quite pleasant. May I?
It's all right, sir. You keep it.
Thanks very much, Emily. Right then, class, where were we? Oh, yes, page 33 and our study of mucus-producing organisms.
Lunchtime. The canteen is buzzing with talk of the mystery VIP.
Oh, what if it's Wayne Rooney?
Nah, I think it's the Prime Minister.
But the staff remain 100% focused on their work. And so to maths with Mr. Conundrum, who encourages his students to apply mathematics to everyday situations.
So, if a man purchases one pair of roller skates on a Friday. The shopkeeper informs him that he has 7 days in which to return them. He falls over 50 times. What is the last day in which he can return them to the shop? Yes, Taj?
Friday.
Friday. And for an extra mark, when is it Friday?
Today, sir.
Today? Right. Fire me! bleeding.
Meanwhile, in product design, Mr. Oakley has fashioned a bespoke chair for the VIP guest.
OK, listen up, men.
I'm not a man.
Ah, but there will be one day, lad. There will be one day.
I won't.
In honour of our special guest today, I have made this chair. It's carved all from a single piece of oak. Any idea of what else can be carved all from a single piece of oak? Yes, son.
A pencil.
A walking stick.
A bowl.
Oh, good. Manly answers, men. But correct answer to question, what else can be carved all from a single piece of oak, is anything. You see now, lads, day'll come, as it did with me, when you finish making your first chair, carved all from a single piece of oak. And you'll be stood holding your chisel, a wooden chisel that you've whittled away with a knife made solely out of oak. And then, and only then, you'll be a man.
I won't.
Oh, you will, son. Now observe, men, as I apply chisel to wood. Man goggles on. Because when you're a man working with wood, as I am a man working with...
In foods technology, Miss Davies has a special treat bubbling away.
As we've got a special assembly straight after this lesson, I thought we should cook a dish for our VIP. And I've gone for something warm and steamy, brown and beefy. Can you hear it bubbling? That means it's ready to come out. Ooh. It's made a bit of a mess on its way out. That's because it's been simmering away in its meaty juices. Smell that. If you inhale really deeply, you can practically taste it.
And so, at the end of the day, the school assembles especially for the special school assembly.
Quiet, please, everyone.
I can now reveal the identity of the special guest that you've all been waiting for. Here to present an award to Mr. Barker is Mrs. Margot Colley, head judge of the Great British Dog Show. Mrs. Colley, we're so thrilled that you could come.
As Mrs. Colley presents Mr. Barker with his dog award, Mr. Christopher presents his cat dance. Celebrate their favourite assembly of the year so far. Mr. Christopher heads for home.
Honestly, let's just
closely followed by Mr. Barker.
Have the tail!
Get your motor running.